Welcome to Danu on Fire Season 3, the Restaurant Edition, made possible by our friends at LICC Jeans. Today on the show, I have a stunning lady who is the author of the book Poison Apple. I'm going to sit and speak to her about her poetry and so much more. I'm happy to have Megan on the show today. Welcome to Danu on Fire. Talking about fire, we are literally just set on fire here.
We are
at Vistas, of course, at the Moenpeek Hotel. This place is known for their brilliant food and, of course, the view as the sun sets. So we are here to capture it and make it a part of the show as well. So this show is all about food and personalities who have actually used great food in part of their life, and at the same time, who have done something wonderful with it. And we just want to speak to this lady here, Megan, who became the latest sensation with the Gaul Lit Fest. And of course, her book that was published late last year, right?
Yes.
Yes. Which I couldn't make it well, unfortunately. I was stuck somewhere.
Yes, I think you were on your way there and...
Yeah, it was impossible for me.
And then you had one of your car things happening.
Ah, yes. I met with the accident.
One of your famous things,
met with the accident. I nearly got thrown to the other end. I was down Vijayarama Road. I'll never forget that because they all... I nearly died. I nearly did die.
At least I can say someone nearly died coming to my book
launch. That is true. All right, to start things off, tell me about your book. From the title, please.
From the title. Okay, so it's called Poison Apple and it's a collection of poetry. Very short poems for those with attention spans of goldfish. The Instagram age, so you can read the five lines and be done with it and come back to it the next day.
If you do, take it into consideration, back in the days, Kavi.
Yes.
They were all written in two lines. But it's just later on we lengthened it to show how intellectual people can be.
And how heavy with words they can be.
And also
and how you need a dictionary for
And
it.
Also created like a doorstopper as a book.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Those big
Yeah. And it's not so pleasant
you
to read that.
Study any of those?
Yeah. Never mind. So tell me. So your book...
So yeah, so Poison Apple is actually a journey through this tumultuous courtship.
Okay.
So there's these two lovers who never get to be with each other.
So these are all narrated through poems?
Yes. So it is a story narrated through poetry. So you meet the lady, you meet the guy, you see what they're like together, and then you have this entire section dedicated to when they break up. So how the guy feels about it and how the girl feels about it. It's a little different how they view this whole loss part of it.
Oh, brilliant.
So yeah, it's a little sad towards the end.
Never mind. You had to make it morbid, no, at one point?
I have to make it. It has to happen. It's
Cheers to the book. Cheers to the book. All right, if you're wondering what are we having here, this is actually an acharu mocktail. Is it nice?
It is.
It really hits the spot.
Mm.
Yeah. You know that infant Jesus spot in Colombo? I don't know how often I went to church. Right after church, I'm there at the acharu counter trying to be like...
It's good.
Yeah, it's really good.
It's like... Adds to the heat here also.
I really needed that. Actually, both of us are sick while we shoot this.
We're on antihistamines so that we don't sneeze during the show.
Correct.
Yeah.
All right, so tell me about your start. You have, before we get to your start,
yes.
Currently you are juggling being a mum, being an entrepreneur of your own. You also do voicing commercials, you script write.
Yes.
You are a wife, you're a daughter.
that's another thing, right?
Yeah. Like 100 other things. Yeah. 100 things that you're doing. Tell me about women and how do you fight for rights?
Oh goodness. So I'm not one of these people who...
write a paragraph on Facebook? Okay.
I don't rant about these type of things. Things are what they are, right? It is what it is. Yes, there are...
Of course, if it's an issue that needs to be addressed, then it has to be addressed.
Yeah, of course. There are the issues that have to be addressed. But I think the worst part of it is that the fact that you have so many hurdles getting up to that point. It's not like a straight line for you when you're a woman. But having said that, you also have your, you get the pluses because you're a woman, you have certain privileges as well.
That is true. Okay, so tell me about juggling all these roles that you live in one day.
So it's interesting in one way, okay. Because in advertising you get to do different clients. So
but
that
it's
part
a firm
it,
that you're running by yourself now.
Myself and my partner, Dilai.
Okay.
So we handle small niche brands. It's interesting because in a day I get to have to do the ads, I get to do voicing, there is my time with my daughter. Mm. When I do get time, then there is the writing that happens. Of course, the writing doesn't happen often enough.
Right.
Because it does need that chunk of time.
And also you need to have it to brew in your head.
Yeah, and sit and do it. But I think it's easier for me to juggle things because I have a lot of help from my mom.
Okay.
So that's a great blessing for me.
All right.
I'm able to do so many things because of that support system.
Now, are you someone who likes to cook?
Yes, a lot.
You can cook?
Yes.
What are you known for?
Crab curry. Yes.
Like a authentic what?
Proper Tamil crab.
All right, Tamil crab curry, superb. All right, we're going to get into a break. We're going to speak a little bit about the fact that she cut her hair off. That's something that I'm like trying to figure out why.
Thank you.
We got the menu. Thank you so very much. So we actually get to choose out of all this, but what I'm going to do is what I always do.
Yes.
Although I try to use my two cents to choose. I let the restaurant or the place where we are dining
suggest.
Choose because
yeah.
Are you someone who can make the decision fast?
No.
Oh, me too.
Especially with food.
Oh my gosh. It takes a
I hate it time. When there are extensive menus because then you're like, what if you make the wrong choice?
And at the same time, you know, the pressure, the peer pressure of other people looking at you like, so have you decided?
No. And the thing is, I'm always the one who orders when we go out.
Right, okay.
So this time I'd like to not order.
No worries.
Somebody order it for me.
Let the executives here, make the decision. All right, let's get into a break. We'll see you on the other side. It's Danu on Fire, made possible by our friends at LICC Jeans. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you after this. It's Danu on Fire as we dine at Vistas. You have to check this place when the sun is setting and of course the traffic is buzzing. We're waiting for the sun to set and this is the ideal place for you to chill in Colombo. Movenpick Hotel has always been so hospitable to the brand Hai itself. We have done so many shows here, so a big thank you to them. With me, I have Megan. She's got a name for herself with a book that she released, The Poison Apple. But why did you name it The Poison Apple?
Because of forbidden love. So it's, you know.
I see. You know that apple is one of the most, it's a symbol of evil. Adam and Eve, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
Yeah, so that's where it came from,
okay,
that whole.
The poison tree. Now you.
Snow White, yeah.
Yeah. Please, I'm going to dig in. What is this called? Because I forget.
These are falafels.
Falafels.
Yeah.
There's a starter dish for us. It's a Arabic.
Mediterranean, I think. Yeah.
Now, I have to go all together in one, right?
I'm not going to be able to do that.
I'm going
to
try.
I'm just going to try and... Oh, can't pick them up, really. Mm.
Like a wade on top.
Yeah, it's nice. An Arabic wade.
Yeah.
Mm. Oh, see, it's green. It's nice.
Yeah.
Inside.
Mm. Have to chew my way in here. Brilliant. Mm. All right. So tell me about your creative process.
Okay, so usually a thought has to strike. Okay. So there has to be a little idea that comes up. even with the poems, even though I am kind of writing on the same theme, which is love and loss at the moment.
Again?
I'm continuing to write that way. Whatever's not in the book, I have my Instagram page, which sort of has that okay. happening. But yeah, so when an idea comes up, I usually pen it down on my phone, let it sit there. Then when I have time, sort of go back to it.
How long do you normally take to write one poem and say, it's done? I can shelf it now, I know I can print it one day.
Anywhere from 2 days to 2 weeks, actually. Okay. Even That's for great. Those 5 lines.
Okay. Because I know, because you always find a better word, a better way, a better flow, and you're always trying to figure out how in the world you can make it better.
Yeah, because I don't want it to come across as just very simplistic writing. Mm. It is simple words, I want it to relate to people.
And also today, but not a lot of people use big words.
Yeah.
They use words that they can understand and that everyone can reach out.
Yeah, for me it's more about the feeling really. If once people read it, they should feel something. Mm. That's what it's about. So I would go back and reread it and see if it kind of puts a picture in your head. So the picture really matters to me.
Yeah.
I suppose because I'm an art director by profession.
Yeah.
So I think pictorially and then
it
the
has
words
to visually
come.
Sit
yeah,
in
it
you.
Has to visually sit
So
in.
Tell me about this book going international. That was a great experience.
Yeah,
because
so
this
I was,
is your first book.
This is my
Do
first
Do you want to
book?
Take another bite?
No, I'll wait.
Okay, fine. I'll eat.
My bites seem to take a while.
Yes. I understand. Okay.
No, so I really wanted to get published instead of self-publishing.
Okay.
Not that there's anything wrong with self-publishing. It's a great way to go. But I think having a publisher sort of gives you
yeah,
a bit of validation
yeah.
as well. So I did go out and start looking for all these publishers all over the world. So I started with India and then slowly from the bigger publishing houses right down to the smaller ones. And then I was lucky enough to get this indie publishing house in San Francisco.
Okay.
And they're the ones who published the book. So the book actually exists in the States.
Yeah. Which is great.
Which is great. It's available on Amazon all over the world. And hopefully it will pick up at the moment. I mean, it's only been a while.
You never know, you might be on Ellen's show. Would you show my clip if you are on it?
Of course.
And tell her that I really like her.
This is my first interviewer.
Yeah. About the book.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think you gave me my first paper interview as well
really?
About the book.
Yeah. Is this your first TV interview?
Yeah.
Oh, great. Even if it was not, thank you. Is this for
wow,
us to share?
A lot of food. And I'm hoping that's real bacon.
It is. Yes.
You know, it's an absolute farce
it's
when
sad,
people
no.
have that whole chicken bacon.
Yeah.
Like, no, why do you
no.
call it bacon?
Then you just call it chicken strips or something.
No, I have to have another bite of this falafel.
So how was it to be a part of Galdit Fest? And this is your first year, it's the first few months since the book came out. And
first book, first time at Galdit Fest. Actually, it was a really good experience, but it was also quite frightening.
But you were also very much welcomed beautifully. Yes. People accepted you very well. And
I mean, I have to be thankful that I was paired up with an award-winning Indian writer for my session.
Okay.
So I read with her.
I was told that you read in your own elements.
Sorry?
That you had actions coming out and
it comes, right?
Right,
when
right.
you start performing your poetry, then it really comes from within.
Right.
But it was a really good experience. I had 3 sessions for the entire festival with different people and by myself. It was really nice.
So tell me, how is your husband in all of this? How supportive is he? Is he someone who likes to read?
No.
No. That was so genuine. You're like, no.
No.
Has he
we
ever,
have shelves and shelves of books.
Has he read your book?
I'm gonna ask him. No, so he's not a reader. But he's very supportive in the fact that I'm
of course.
With it, all my stuff that I have to do, no.
Okay.
It's not something he's into. Me and my daughter, we read.
Oh, okay.
We're big readers.
Right.
So we're always with a book.
Okay. What is she reading currently?
She's reading Harry Potter.
Okay.
4.
Has she read Diary of a Wimpy Kid?
Yes.
I love it.
She reads quite a few different types.
I must tell you, while everyone was so intellectually gathered, the intellects gathered.
At the Lit Fest, I met you then.
And there I was with Diary of a Wimpy Kid in my car for just guilt reading. That's all I love to read. That's my favorite. I always wait for the newest edition.
So you haven't read my book, right?
No, I haven't. I thought you would bring it today, but you didn't. I can't buy it off Amazon when I know you.
No, of course not. Yeah. But you'll have to read it though.
I will read it, I'll read it. Unless you read it for me or give me an audio version of the book.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you an audiobook person?
Yeah, I love audiobooks.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What are you listening to?
Nothing.
I'm supposed to react to that.
Yeah. I have actually listened to one audiobook.
Okay.
I think it was Ellen's.
Ah. So audiobooks are catching on quite a bit.
Yeah. That's for people like
us. And it's a good idea.
And also it gives you a visual element to your book. Like you get to dream and create your own characters.
And also I guess listen to it in someone's voice.
It's much more nicer. Yeah.
It takes a longer time to finish the book though.
Yeah.
Because it's at the reader's pace.
Yeah. And you sound good, so it'll be great. We're going to get into a break. And I'm going to dig into this fish and chips and whatever this...
The club sandwiches.
Club sandwiches looks really nice. We'll see you after the break. Do stick around. It's Danu on Fire right here on Hi TV, your luxury channel. Welcome back, it's Danu on Fire. We are at this fabulous place, Movenpick Hotel. Thank you so very much for hosting us. We are at Vistas. All right, I'm talking to Megan. She is the author of the book, Poison Apple, which was released last year. It's also available on Amazon. Make sure you buy it. It's in Trump's hand right now. Trump might be reading it, you never know. It's in
the
US.
Trump should read it. I don't know if he'll get anything though.
But yeah. At least he will. So, we have got fruits for... your fork is on the other side. But anyway, we have got fruits for dessert. I don't know why. I think my crew
because
really wants
me
to...
supposed to be healthy. I think they looked at us and thought, let's give them the healthy stuff.
These guys here wanted us to lose weight. They're like, nee, Danu wedding khana hai.
Wedding
khana. Anyway, I've just got myself some love cake. You get that also at Vistas.
Food is one of the biggest pleasures of life. Right?
Yes. Why would you ever stop it? Never mind. All right, coming back. So you stand for a few causes that are very close to you. Eat the pineapple while you talk.
I'm trying, yeah.
She does a project with her friend, who is an artist, a brilliant artist, of course.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Yes.
Dila. She showcased very recently at the Lionel Went Art Gallery, and she was her model for her neckline. So tell me about the project that you all do together. And she is your business partner.
Yes,
well.
So Delia Joseph. She's my business partner. And so we have this little pet project of ours we call Divorce the Device.
Yeah. I love the name.
Right.
They asked me to
campaign it. Yeah, we wanted you to be an advocate of it.
Yeah.
It's basically like a small movement that helps people switch off from their devices for some part of the day.
Yeah.
I know it's impossible to just completely let go.
But yet if you
I also can't do it.
But intentionally if you make a decision?
Intentionally if you make a decision for at least a couple of hours a day, I'm not going to touch it. It will make a big difference.
And
especially,
you know,
people with kids.
Yeah.
How they're also always glued to the phone. When they're at restaurants, the parents are like, here, watch
cartoons.
Here's
the phone, yeah. Correct. And that's not exactly the right thing to do.
No.
And something that Megan actually told me, we were actually discussing, was the fact that, you know, if we do not have these smartphones and information that could be so fast, we will actually not have so many problems.
True.
Yeah, because right now I'm shooting when I'm going through like a bit of a crunch time in my own life, not something so serious, but somebody has forwarded a picture.
And,
yeah. But, you know, all that happened because it can happen.
Yeah, and you're always contactable.
Yeah.
People can find you no matter what.
Even if you go on annual leave, they have somehow got hold of you.
Yeah, and then there's the whole social media validation part of it that happens. You don't get likes on things. You're like,
you know
the
what?
Measurement of
I fall into the category
is a bit
2,000 views, one like. That's my category. Then I have
you're being a little harsh.
No, it's the truth. Like 45.8K views, two likes.
This is YouTube. You're not used to liking things on
Facebook.
YouTube.
Facebook.
Okay.
And you get to know that side as well.
So that's why we kind of started.
How are you all working on it right now?
It sort of went to a standstill because it was difficult to convince people to actually do it. What we wanted for people to do was when they have events around Colombo,
right,
to start with.
Okay.
So they say you've got an open mic happening or you've got some sort of event, right?
Go enjoy the event.
Go enjoy the event. Leave your phones at the door. We'll have a box. We'll collect it. You know, leave your phones. After the event, come back. So because when you go to even watch like a music performance, people are watching it there. They're not actually engaging with the performance. They're not taking anything in. There is research to prove that, you know, when you take so many pictures of things, you actually forget the moment that you were in. So when you're traveling, for instance, you're always taking the picture, but you forgot
where you were, how it
what
smelled.
You saw, nothing. Yeah. None of that gets in. So it was just to get people aware of that and just to advise them not to misuse the technology sometimes.
So what's the next book you're going to work on? Is it going to be a continuation of?
No, so I am thinking of a short prose kind of thing because I like all forms of writing.
One day they'll quote you. Make.
One day, I hope.
I'll quote you. The minute you release it.
On like Goodreads quotes or something with my name before I die.
I will quote you tomorrow. Just send me a quote, I'll put it up.
I haven't started working on it properly. It's still an idea. I don't want to push myself and think, you know, I have to do it because then the good stuff won't come out. I'll wait until it happens and then hopefully.
All right. So I'm of course genuinely very proud of her for the fact that she had to step out from her full-time job because she got married, she had a kid, and you know, she had to divide her time and fairly.
Fair.
And I think you need to. I think being a part of a child's upbringing and
it's very important.
That's and also that's treasured. Like like our moms have great memories of us. Although my mom could have had the option to work, she was fortunate enough to stay back.
Yeah.
And it's actually luxury now.
Course.
To stay back and look after your child, because I don't think you can do it anymore.
No, I don't think people have the choice anymore.
And that's why you had to find ways of earning money but yet being there for your child. And that's important. Megan, big respect for you
for all what
you have done and all what you have achieved. And I hope to see you doing so much bigger at Gauntlet Fest next time around.
Hope so.
And internationally as well.
There is another book.
So follow her on social media or read her book if you can. Support local talent. It's something that we always speak loud about. Thank you for joining us.
Thank
will see you,
Danu.
With a yum edition. My love cake never came.
Enjoy the fruit, Danu. Yeah. They're sending us a message.
Fine. We'll see you with another brilliant episode next week. That's on Danu on Fire. Big thank you to LICC Jeans for being a part of the show. Until I see you soon, take care.